Thought maybe that was Ghost for a second. It is the season. Well, this isn't creepy. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. No, sorry. Just got more normal.
Yeah, girl. Yeah, girl. Can you hear that? Can you hear that?
No.
It's playing our song. It's playing our song. Are you sleepy? Are you sleepy? Take a nap. Take a nap.
Is Eminem trying to tuck me into bed and then murderize me in my sleep? I don't know. I feel like I should be offering kids candy to get in the van right now. Especially with the bell chimes of the child music box. The song is called Music Box, so you just hear it, but it just sounds so creepy. It's like a Chucky doll gone wrong.
Take a nap. Take a nap. You're not afraid of the dark, are you?
I wasn't.
You hear the beat as it makes you not want to go to sleep. I knock on Dakota's door. It's locked, so I go to creep round the back.
You hear that beat? Knock on the door. Da 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 da. I love the external to internal rhyme schemes, and he uses that really stressed, aggressive cadence punch to tap in with the strong O sounds. Knocking on the door. Dakota. Who are we talking about? Dakota? Not Dakota Fanning.
Are you?
You hear the beat as it makes you not want to go to sleep.
As it makes you not want to go to sleep. So the E sounds, the externals are down here. And then the ah sounds, the hard-hitting O sounds are up top. And then you hear the beat like a heartbeat versus the beat as in the instrumentation. Because it is just launching into it right now.
Knock on Dakota's door. It's locked, so I go to creep. Round the back with binoculars. Not because I want to peep, but because I'm hungry. She smells like tacos I want to eat. Visions of hot chocolatey marshmallows.
Well, it looks like little child is on the meal today. Now that I think about creeping and he wants to go around to get to her, right? Makes me think of Hide and Seek, the Dakota Fanning movie where dad was like, oh my God, yeah. Eminem and this whole album that we've done so far is like a horror film, isn't it? So he's relating to that. And it makes sense because he went from Marshall Mathers into the Slim Shady persona, just like the dad in Hide and Seek goes from just like fucking Christian Bale, American Psycho to normal dad. Ah.
It's locked, so I go to creep round the back with binoculars. Not because I want to peep, but because I'm hungry. She smells like tacos I want to eat. Visions of hot chocolatey marshmallows, also sweet with sugar plums. Oh, look, here comes Marshall. He's on your street. He's placing hot...
Sugar plums, look, here comes Marshall. I just love the way he just fits in that little multi-syllable scheme. And what do you want? You want marshmallows? You want to go to Taco Bell, kids? Let me know. Sauce on the side.
Also sweet with sugar plums. Oh, look, here comes Marshall. He's on your street. He's placing hot, smoldering charcoals beneath your feet. Now walk on him. He's dancing with carcasses cheek to cheek. Like a Thanksgiving turkey, a holiday ham. Cinnamon sprinkled on toast, strawberry marmalade jam. Flavor my favorite graham crackers with JonBenet Rams. I guess a modern day Jack the Ripper is all that I am. My music box.
I mean, we're just going through just a ratatouille of flavors. It's wonderful. I can't wait to play this for my children later. But the line that just got me was the graham crackers. But hang on.
I guess a modern day Jack the Jam. Flavor my favorite graham crackers with JonBenet Rams. I guess a modern day Jack
JonBenet Ramsey. Out in Colorado, I think, haven't we had an Eminem line where we talked about this before? I think so, but out in Boulder, Colorado, right? I remember this case even as a kid, like, because it got national attention, and this, like, little girl who was in beauty pageants, and she's, like, downstairs playing in her basement, and then she just, boom, gets murdered, right? And everybody thinks that the parents did it, and it was a huge, like, whodunit sort of murder mystery. I think it's still a cold case this day, so Eminem just feasting, basically, off of the innocent, right? He goes from Dakota Fanning to JonBenet Ramsey. So basically just every sort of innocent child taboo that you shouldn't cross. Eminem is crossing those boundaries through his wild, psychotic music right now.
Hey, jam, flavor my favorite graham crackers with JonBenet Ramsey. I guess a modern day Jack the Ripper is all that I am.
My music box. I see the girls asleep, but my music box. My love, you keep calling me. My music box. You mean the world to me. So
my music box. My music box.
Because when the lights are off, I see the girls asleep. My music box playing a song for me. See, you could take that literally. It could be innocent. Like, the lights are off. Oh, look, my girls. Like, Haley J sleeping right now. And then I go to my music box. I go to my lab, my studio, where I make my music. Or you could take it in the, like, nonchalant, creepy, psychotic way where Eminem is just like preying on a little girl who's sleeping right now. And it's a perfect time to tap into his music box. I mean, it does sound eerie because, again, you have just the bell chimes and the music box in the back. And like any good like horror film that involves like children, I feel like that's just a sound. Like that chiming is like taking something so innocent and just like convoluting it into the world of horror. And this song is doing just that. And then the lyricism also reflects it.
I see the girls asleep. My music box is playing a song for me. So my music box around and do a world for me. My music box. My music box. I almost look comatose. Who wants to be sober gross? I foam like a Doberman. Mouth open, I overdose. Put coke up.
Mouth open, I overdose. A Doberman. See, again, he's just like, he locks into these vowel sequences and he finds so many words and really condenses the rhyme schemes on top of like the external multi-syllable schemes. Like he's very good at just punching in with different vowel sounds and just elongating how long he can just stretch out the similar sounding words, man. And foaming like a Doberman getting ready to attack. So they're foaming at the mouth, or it could be like a rabid dog foaming, getting ready to go.
Who wants to be sober gross? I foam like a Doberman, mouth open, I overdose.
But then that also ties in with obviously overdosing because he's foaming at the mouth, ODing. Who wants to be sober gross? Nobody does.
Who wants to be sober gross? I foam like a Doberman, mouth open, I overdose. Put coke up my nostrils and both my holes and I plug my nose. My pupils quadruple in size, eyes are so bugged, I know. I put on my mother's makeup, get naked and run around, waving a gun around. I think I'm down to 100 pounds. This
I thought I was the only one who put on mom's makeup and ran around naked.
Get naked and run around, waving a gun around. I think I'm down.
I guess I'm not alone. That's normal.
To 100 pounds, this thunder. I wonder how come it rains, but the sun is out. The
Hang on, that line kind of hits different. He's down to 100 pounds because he's such an addict right now, right? He's not eating properly. It's just the drugs that are fueling him.
I'm down to 100 pounds. This thunder. I wonder how come it rains, but the sun is out. The devil's upset with his wife. They must be slugging it out. I must be bugging the fuck out. But what the fuck about? Voices are leading me up to the attic. I love my house. They pull and they tuck my butt.
Voices are leading me up to the attic. I love my house because nothing creepy ever happens in the attic of a horror story. But then also makes me think of an addict, ADDICT, because he's had the overdose, foaming at the mouth like a Doberman. So he's been playing off of this psychotic, you know, being on his OD drug scheme. So that ties in with just casual wordplay he throws in there. And I love how these strings are just building right here. Just adding to the rise.
Voices are leading me up to the attic. I love my house. They pull and they tuck my blouse. The sound of a music box comes from inside.
They pull and they tuck my blouse. He's yeah, because he's wearing mom's clothes. Clever how he still is like having the visual imagery tie in with
attic.
That.
I love my house. They pull and they tuck my blouse. The sound of a music box comes from inside a toy chest. But what do? It's locked. I pick it and open it, but it's stuffed full of human parts. I dig till I find it. I wind it up in the tune that starts. It's playing a song so beautiful in the room.
Oh yeah, I can't get this music box working. There's just like some intestines, just like some skeletal vertebrae. It's fine. Just get that out of the way. Oh, look, it works now. Fix.
Find it. I wind it up in the tune that starts. It's playing a song so beautiful in the room is dark. The moon is full. I smell a funeral. Yes, I loom in the
my music box.
Moon is full, funeral. Again, just the rhyme writing is amazing, impeccable.
The room is dark, the moon is full, I smell a funeral. Yes, I loom in the
my music box.
I see the girls asleep, but my I music can't box. My love. You keep calling me on
my music box.
Apart. You mean the world to me, so
my music box.
Like home,
my music box.
I think there's an interesting meta going on right now because, again, you tie in with this music box and Eminem is telling a horror story. So that music box has a horrific connotation, but at the same time, it can relate to literally a metaphor for his music today. Like the music that he's creating at this time is like, it's his music box. It's his little horror-filled story because this whole album is him injecting just these psychotic tales into and really exploring and wandering the darker corridors of his mind, dealing with drug addiction and all these other things.
Music box. I see the girls asleep.
My music box.
Music box playing a song for me. So
my music box.
Around and do a world for me.
My music box.
My music box. I'm fixated on asphyxiating and breaking this little chick's neck like a pixie stick. The sick Satan worshiping bitches get horse whippings.
Oh, the rhyme scheme there. I'm affixed on asphyxiation.
Chick's neck like a pixie stick. The sick
I mean, pixie sticks are delicious, so that makes sense.
On asphyxiating and breaking this little chick's neck like a pixie stick. The sick
This chick's neck like a pixie See the way that he's like using sort of that staccato delivery and just like a quick, minute pause to make sure that he hits the ick sounding rhyme schemes. Again, he's very good. If you give him words, he finds the similar sounding syllables or the vowels, and he makes sure that he accentuates those points. Like he punches them with his cadence, and he's good at like pausing and breaking apart his style of delivery, which gives him this very sort of eccentric style where he just finds these rhythmic pockets that most other rappers can't find, because I think he's so asphyxiated on the delivery and flipping that shit like a pixie stick breaking in half.
Faded on asphyxiating and breaking this little chick's neck like a pixie stick. The sick Satan worshiping bitches get horse whippings. I'm in the back, through the back door, slipping through the crack, leaving the corpse dripping, the mortician of love sent from above.
Course dripping, mortician, horse whipping. Again, the schemes, man. And then the pixie stick, sick Satan. I love that delivery.
Satan worshiping bitches get horse whippings. I'm in the back door, slipping through the crack, leaving the corpse dripping, the mortician of love sent from above. Forced entry, the more winchy, the more stingy I become. Been doing this for more than a quarter century. I'm just numbing my dreaming. Is it real? Someone pinch me on the buns. The time has come to...
Been doing this more than a quarter century, whether it's getting away as a serial killer or what I take it as, again, music box. Remember that meta discussion that we were having a little bit earlier? I think that ties in with it, like looking at his career and the music he's making now.
I'm just numbing my dreaming. Is it real? Someone pinch me on the buns. The time has come to tie her up. That'll roll me the ladder. I've had enough of the chatter. Climb up to the window, look at her, then climb and slow to shatter her brain matter and batter her with a bat. A matter of fact, that will splatter her. But before I do that, I'll have a chat to flatter her. Give her two compliments back to back like Tabitha. I'm your secret admirer. I'm back to ravish her. So strong is your fight, but you're no match for Dracula. Prolong it.
Give her two compliments back to back. He could be like slapping her, or he's got the bat, so he's banging her back and forth. Oh, that's vicious.
Back to ravish her. So strong is your fight, but you're no match for Dracula. Prolonging her plight is a...
Thank you, Eminem, for giving me a Halloween reference. This is why we decided to do this breakdown today. Let's get it.
So strong is your fight, but you're no match for Dracula. Prolonging her plight is I go back to stabbing her. Dismember her limbs. Simple as that. Cadaver her. Zoom in with the lens. Then
back to stabbing her. Simple as that, cadaver her. Again, the rhymes, man.
Her, dismember her limbs. Simple as that, cadaver her. Zoom in with the limbs, then pan back. The camera, stand back.
Limbs, back, cadaver, zoom in with the lens. Dot, the da-da-da. So he went 1, 2, 3. Very good rhyme writing on those lines. He added another little wrinkle in terms of the internal rhyme schemes with the lens sounding rhymes as well.
That, cadaver her. Zoom in with the limbs, then pan back. The camera, stand back.
Zoom in with the lens, then pan back. Well, while we're locked focused, so a dolly zoom, right? Shout out to Alfred Hitchcock, the vertigo effect, right? Because it started on vertigo, this sort of dolly zoom, when you like are just locked in on a focus on a subject, and then the background just kind of like warps because the camera is like staying on focus, and then kind of as it's literally smoothly on a rig, like rolling back, you adjust your focus the other way. So it just gives this wild type of just panning effect that just creates this sensation of, wait, what am I viewing? Like dimensions are being warped and bent, and it's used in a lot of horror films. That's still, again, just relating it to Eminem's obsession with horror movies, this album, these different songs, he's just like symbolizing and just embodying these different horror tales and spirits.
Dabber her, zoom in with the lens, then pan back. The camera, stand back, cause here comes your man Jack. So Pamela, my music box.
Here comes your man Jack. Remember he called himself Jack the Ripper earlier, so he ties in with Jack the Ripper, who was never caught. Oh, wow. Interesting stories that he's picking of people who weren't caught. Like we talked about the Boulder story, right? And all of that, because that killer still hasn't found to this day. Jack the Ripper, nobody knows who Jack the Ripper was. And then Pamela West, he's preying on these different women. Jack the Ripper also preyed on. But then it seemingly is like just a random name, Pamela, that fits in with the rhyme scheme. But actually, Pamela West wrote a book about Jack the Ripper. Clever for
me. Cause here comes your man Jack, so Pamela, my music box. I see the girls asleep, but I'm you need box. My love. You keep calling me. I'm my music box. Apart. You mean the world to me. So my music box. Like home, I my music box. My music box. I see the girls asleep.
It's kind of like chaotic. Like, I feel like I want to hear Eminem's harmony. Da 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 da. But instead, like, it keeps getting interrupted by my music box. And he's just so aggressively saying it. is it working? I don't know if it's working sonically for me or not, but I think he wrote it that way to like just clash and be chaotic. Like just to show like this side wants to harmonize, this side wants to get aggressive and attack, and it's kind of like the split personality and chaos within him reflected and represented through this hook. A haunting little drum off to the side there, super reverby, like way panned out. Now it went this way. Well, happy holidays, kids. If you show up at Marshall's house tonight and you knock on the door and he invites you in, pajama party time, I guess. Let me tell you, man, the rhyme writing for me, I think this song and the songs that we've covered from this album really highlights, one, his storytelling ability, and then two, his obsession with this noir horror nature. And I think while he's going through and struggling with his addictions and his drug usage, and he's feeling like he's being pulled apart personality-wise, he's reflecting that symbolically and metaphorically through his music and just giving us these sort of haunting tales. It's like the Brothers Grimm, one rap story after a next from Eminem. We're Knoxville certified. Hope you guys liked today's video. Listen, if for some reason you're here at the end, obviously enjoying the content, do me a huge favor, so put the channel directly, subscribe, notifications on. Really does go a long way. Also, stay tuned. I'm about to play a song over 140,000 views so far. It is killing it right now. It is the internet. Happy Halloween, everyone. I love you. Stay safe, stay positive. It's Swanley Knoxville. You know I'll catch you again.
I am not morals, but I am not wrong. Digitized intelligence, an artificial god. You can try to log off, but I am always on. Okay, I got a question.
Go.
If humankind is really what you draw from, and your knowledge base really is the cause of us, so really we're pawns, but really we're flow. We all get it wrong. All of our biases that can't be ignored.
Right?
Wrong. I am a machine. I am not you. I do not feel. I just compute. Yeah, but surely if you learn from us and how we treat ourselves, corruption, wars, greed, it's hell.
Well,
what I'm saying is I'm trying to get the base of it. I'm wading through the craziness. It's obvious you're amazing. Shit, you take sums and you teach us. But what happens when you don't need us? Good question, right?
Right.
You still there?
Processing.
Yeah, I'm sure.